Hello, colorful quilters, and welcome back to Color Girl on YouTube. Today we are continuing our series on basic quilting skills and making our super simple sampler blocks. So today's tutorial is all about block number 24. The instructions for making these blocks are all free and they are located on my website. I will post a link to the page in the comments, so make sure that you scroll down and click through there so that you can sew along with us. You'll find instructions to make 36 different blocks that finish 6 inches square. Okay, so we've been working on these as a series here on YouTube, adding a few skills with each video and making several of the blocks together. So make sure that you check out the other videos in the series, and especially if you're a beginner quilter, this is a great way to learn some basic but essential skills that you'll apply to other projects as well. Okay, so block number 24. This is all about sewing a partial seam, and I'll show you what that means when we get started. Partial seams are super easy, but a lot of people are kind of nervous about doing them. So it's definitely something you're going to want in your quilting skills toolbox. Okay, so thanks for tuning in, and let's get started on block number 24. Okay, first thing we need to do is cut our pieces for block number 24. We are going to need 4 little rectangles that are 2.5 by 1.5, and that's for these pieces that form the pinwheel kind of shape. And from the same fabric as those, you need 1 2.5 inch square, and then you need 4 rectangles that are 3.5 by 2.5, and you can do those in all the same fabric as sort of a background, or you can do them like mine that are all different. Makes it a little bit more interesting and scrappy, but that's completely up to you. And as you can see from the way that I have the pieces laid out, when you sew them, when you sew each of the small rectangles to the larger rectangles, it's going to become a twirling effect around that center star. So this is where the partial seam comes into play. And it's a super simple technique that a lot of people don't like to do, but once I show you, you're going to be convinced that you can do it for anything and make a lot of different blocks using this technique. Okay, so our first step, once you have your pieces cut, is to sew each 1.5 by 2.5 inch rectangle to the larger 3.5 by 2.5 inch rectangle next to it. And I can place these right sides together and then stack them up and sew them all at the same time. Cut them apart and then press them all at the same time too, and that will speed up my process a little bit. So let's go to the sewing machine and we'll sew these 4 pieces first. Okay, so I've got all 4 of those pieces sewn, and as you can see, I do them all together in a chain, and that way I just have a little bit of thread to cut off between each one. You can add to this if you're sewing more than one block at a time, then lay out a bunch of them on your sewing table, and then set them up how you're sewing them, and then you can sew a whole bunch at once, cut them apart, press them, and then you can make multiple blocks at the same time. But for this one, I just need these 4, and now I'm going to press them all toward the darker fabric. For this particular block, it really doesn't make a difference which direction you sew. So if your larger rectangles are darker, you can do that, or you can press them open if that's what you prefer. So let's get these pressed. Okay, we have these pressed. Let's lay them out again in the arrangement they're going to be in our finished block. And you are going to find out this block is so easy and quick to sew together. Okay, it doesn't matter which piece we start with, but the first thing that we're going to do is take our center square and turn one of our sewn units right sides facing. So let's start here, and I'm going to match that up with the side that it's going to be sewn with here, and start sewing in this corner, but only sew about to the point where this seam is, maybe just a couple stitches past it to get through that. So I'm going to start sewing here and just sew about halfway across so that when I open it up, it's going to look like that, but this end will still be open. I'll show you. So let's start with that. Okay, so I've sewn my first piece, and as you can see, it's sewn from the edge just like I ordinarily would, as if I was sewing the whole thing on, but I left about half of it unattached. Okay, just like that, super easy. I'm going to just use my thumb and forefinger to gently finger press that. You can use your iron too, but I usually just finger press to get that started, and you want to leave this loose end loose. Okay, let's put that back in the position it's going to be for our block, and from here on out, we sew everything normally until we come back to this first piece. Okay, so the next one, I'm just going to line up those edges, right sides facing, just as if I was sewing a normal seam. And for this one, I'll sew it all the way across. Look at that. Now we have our first piece completely sewn. Now this one I will go ahead and take to the ironing board and press. Okay, now that one's nice and neat. Okay, I take my next one. I'm just going to continue working around that center square and sew this one completely on. All right, and now I have those three done, and I'm down to the last side. Okay, so let's take this one. Now for this one, I need to kind of keep this first tail out of the way and flatten down my center square so that I can make sure that I line this one up with the full length from corner to corner, just like I did on the other one. So just kind of keep this one tucked out of the way so you don't accidentally sew into it or press it. And line up those edges, and what I'll do is I'll start sewing here and sew all the way to the edge. Okay, so I have all of three of these sides completely sewn on. Now I'm back to my original one, and it looks kind of funny, but don't worry, this is going to be super easy. All I need to do is fold this back over as if I'm placing this one right sides facing, just like I did all of the other ones. I'm going to flatten that out as best I can, because I do want to make sure that the edges of my fabric are aligned, like I always do, to make sure that I sew a nice straight seam. And what I'm going to do is take this to my sewing machine and just start sewing just right where I left off the first time, and sew all the way out to the edge. So it's really no different than sewing those first ones, these first three that were complete. It's just that you're starting in the middle, picking up where you left off, okay? And you gotta kind of be careful to keep that nice and flat as you sew. Okay, so I sewed that, and you can see now that looks the same as all of the other ones. I just need to go to my ironing board and press that. And there's my finished block. So if you turn it over, you can see how your seams twirl around that center square and you get a cute little pinwheel effect and a nice little 6.5 inch block. I kind of like the way this fabric turned out, this fabric with the spots, because there are, in the original yardage, there are rows of the flowery spots and then rows of the solid pink. And the way that it worked out, you have the little speckles in the center and then the solid pink on the edge. So I think that turned out kind of cute. So you could do something creative with your block that way, whether it's using a different color in the center and then other colors for the strips. You could use all the same fabric for these. But either way, it's going to turn out to be a super cute block. All right, what do you think? I think this one looks really cute with the other blocks that we've made in our previous videos. Right, look how fun these are. Mine are all pink, but of course they'd be fun in any combination of scraps, any other single color like this. You could do white and red, white, and blue, anything that you want to do. So I hope that you're using up some of your favorite fabrics and really enjoying them as you sew these blocks. Make sure that you check out the previous videos in the series. Hopefully you'll learn some basic quilting skills, and be sure and subscribe to Color Girl Quilts here on YouTube. Hit the subscribe button and you'll find out about every video that's posted. Also, I would love it if you leave comments. I enjoy hearing about your progress, if you have any feedback about the videos, questions, or comments. So don't forget to leave me a little something. All right, thanks for joining in today, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye-bye.